une économie en croissance pour être soutenable, pour être durable, du point de vue de la gestion non renouvelable,
and renewable, a renewable economy needs to meet three requirements. Three requirements which are first and foremost to have very high level of recycling efficacy, 60 to 80%. Then an addition to stock level which is below 20% of material consumption. So when we consume 100 tons of a given raw material, 80% goes back to waste and only 20% are added to the goods that we currently use. So the second requirement is a low level of addition to stocks or recycling, which is high. And the third requirement, we need growth of raw materials to be below 1%, to be low. There is no sustainable solution if the growth rate is above 1%, and even less so if it's above 2 to 3%. If we look at the case of the UK, for instance, and more specifically the case of the emblematic material of industrial revolution, as it happens, we have very fine accounting of the use of materials carried out by the London College at the beginning of years 2000, and we see that we can look at the effective data of British economy with regards to these three criteria, and we see that the growth rate in consumption between 1980 and 2000 is 1.122%. We see that the efficacy of recycling is of about 71% in the UK, and the accumulation level is 31%, so the production of waste is of 100%, and when they consume 100 tons of steel in the UK, 31 are added to the goods which are being used on the surface of the planet, whereas 69 are replacing materials which were sent to waste and recycled. Now, comparing to the criteria that I mentioned earlier, we see that we can be rather optimistic, but that we've not made it yet. The growth rate is still too high as compared to the 1% target. We see that recycling efficacy is satisfactory if the two other criteria were observed, but it's probably not sufficient because consumption is growing slightly too high, and we're still accumulating too much steel in the UK. More than 20%, which would be the proper limit, fully realizing that this is an indicative limit. So we're not yet producing enough steel waste as compared to what they consume in the UK. It is important because we all understand that emerging economies need to accumulate in order to reach an acceptable lifestyle and to cope with their growing population. This is the UK is the oldest economy in industrial revolution. Railways were built in the 19th century. Collective facilities were built in the UK, like in France, like in Germany, for more than 1.5 centuries. The UK have been part of the richest economy on the planet for a very long time now, but yet we see that they still accumulate a lot of additional material, a lot of additional goods. So this is a society which is a society of accumulation as much as it is a society of consumption and waste. Even when you are an affluent society, we'll still use our wealth to accumulate goods. And even when the growth of population is low, as was the case in the UK over this period of time, we'll still consume more than the rest of the population. And it's not because affluent or rich countries have a low demography and a high standard of living that they achieve a theoretical threshold in which our needs being completed, covered, we can stop going for material growth, we can stop accumulating additional goods. This is not the case, even in a country like the UK, for such a basic material like iron, we still have criteria that do not comply with sustainability objectives. So this is a real society challenge that won't be sorted out easily. It's deeply complex, but it's all about rethinking how we consume. It's about rethinking our economic growth model and be successful with and rebuild business models, industrial models, and cultural models so that we can disconnect the growth of wealth, which is required to create jobs and to ensure democracy, and to guarantee the society model we enjoy today, to disconnect this from material requirements and disconnect our feeling of wealth from the accumulation of material goods. This is a beautiful challenge and a prerequisite to make the economy of raw materials sustainable.